To big dog. A big dog needs a lot of food to be kept in a good condition. So they developed bull dogs. These were dogs that were still able to handle bulls, especially dangerous if they broke loose, and also were kept especially by the butchers. And you see that in other countries, as I mentioned before, for example, Alano Español was held in the Spanish countries for this purpose, but they developed in the United Kingdom a smaller type of dog that was still handle it and even do it better, because they have less weight as compared to the strength of the jaws. So the dogs developed enormous muscles and relatively low weight, because if a bull tried to shake off a bulldog, hey, then it would be harder to shake off a lighter dog, because of course they would be easier to be thrown into the air, less sensitive forces applied. Those forces would make, for example, a dog to try to handle the bull break off the bull, and then the bull was set free again. That was not something that they wished, but they developed a dog that would handle it, focus a specific area of the bull, oftentimes the nose or the ears, and as such was able to put its will on those bulls. And by doing so, they had dogs from about 60 pounds, it would be 27 kilograms, that would be doing the job that normally a Molosso of 40 to 50 kilograms would do. So almost half the size and the same or better performance. That was the bulldog. And the bulldogs of old look very much like the American Pitbull Terriers of today. Perhaps a little bit heavier. They also look a lot more like the Staffordshire Bull Terrier than they do the current day bulldogs. How come? Because current day bulldogs have a lot of other blood issues, especially pug blood, which is like a lapdog type of dog, to flatten the skull and shorten the nose further, and is completely unfunctional. Handling bull, but also sometimes deer baiting. But after a while, also those lots of us, so to say, being able to handle bull could be beneficial, especially for the villagers. One would break loose, but bears would be declining as a threat. So those blood sports, as they were now, became also illegal. And then they turned to, okay, what could we do with those bulldogs? They set those bulldogs up against each other, because it was harder to find out. And it was already also done. Sometimes they tested which of the bulldogs would be the best one by sending them against each other. And that would be the test of two equals. So of course a bull is very strong and also very big, but it's not threat to do that type of gladiator stuff, where these dogs were. And that resulted in the first pit dogs, or canine dogs, that were specifically bred for that purpose. The dogs you see here on the leash is in the Patterdale Terrier. It's like a smaller bull terrier type of dog, and I will come to that in a later phase as well, because I like it. Oi oi! Because next to the pits where the dogs were fighting each other, they also had pits where dogs were fighting rats. And of course, a rat is very little of an opponent compared to a dog. But what they did.